Captain for life.
Yeah, that's it.
Who is he?
He's our photographer. He's telling you, you know.
Yes.
Not up to British Rail standards then.
Maybe roaring with a zoom like a zoom like a wee, but there isn't any roar when the clock strikes four. Everything stops for tea. Oh, a lawyer in a courtroom in the middle of an alimony plea has to stop, let him fall when the clock strikes four. Everything stops for tea. It's a very good English custom for the weather be cold or hot. If you need a little pickup, your little G-cup will always hit the spot. Soldiers may be fighting in the trenches or a battleship at sea, but there isn't any war when the clock strikes four. Everything stops for tea.
Thank you.
my husband, although he's been British for nearly 60 years, he does still feel a bit of a foreigner, but I think asking him to do this has made him feel, you know,
truly British.
So thank you very much indeed. You know my occupation. Yeah. I can keep going for 8 hours. almost 50 years to the day we bought our land in Spar Road, although we didn't move in till next year. And I'm giving you warning, we're having a big party next year that you'll all be invited to celebrate the 50 years. But I've never ceased to think that Bracebrough is an absolutely wonderful place to be. Mm. When you read in the papers and you look on the television, we seem a world apart. So I think it's wonderful here, and I don't ever want to leave Bracebrough. Bit of a history lesson now. This is only the second Diamond Jubilee that there's ever been in the whole history of the United Kingdom. The last one was Queen Victoria's in 1897. So 115 years later, we're celebrating again. Now, when it was her Diamond Jubilee, the village had a whip round and raised enough money to buy the gate to the church, which is still there. So I think it's appropriate that we've also made our mark for the village. Mm. It's taken me 13 years to get this, but I've got it. And now comes the commercial break. It's for everybody, this flagpole. Please use it. It's for anniversaries, births, marriages, anything. I'm afraid there is a donation involved, but it goes to a good cause. So please use the flag. You can have the Union flag, you can have the flag of St George, but if you want anything else, you've got to provide it. And I'll give you fair warning, there will be a strange flag up, and it will be red and white, and it will be Polish, and we've got it already. So that will be going up too. But before I ask my husband to raise the flag, I want to mention some very special persons who I think is hiding at the back. Mr. Paul Morris. Is he hiding there?
Yes, he is.
He's hiding there. You may not know who Paul Morris is, but he's the most recent resident in the village, and he's moved into the thatch cottage the entrance to the village. And it's thanks to Paul that you've got this flagpole, because he has given it to the village. Not only has he given it to the village, he erected it at no cost to the village whatsoever. So thank you very much indeed, Paul. And I think he's going to fit in very well in this village.
It carries on like that.
Yeah.
And before I ask Hugo to raise the flag, I'm going to embarrass Paul terribly. My husband may not be strong enough to raise the flag, so would you like to come and help him raise the flag? Now you know why I wanted you here.
Jennifer.
Thank you.
better. Well done, all of you.
Oh.
No, that comes earlier. No.